Hi, and welcome to the second video on the hardest GCSE problems of all time. Now, in case you're outside the UK, GCSEs are exams that students in England and Wales do when they're about 16 years old. And these are particularly notoriously difficult questions that a very small percentage of students got right nationally. So let's look at the question first. We've got a diagram showing a hexagon A, B, C, D, E, F. We've got A, B, E, F, which is this shape here, and C, B, E, D here. They're both congruent parallelograms. Remember that a parallelogram is a quadrilateral, a four-sided shape, where you've got two pairs of parallel sides. And congruent just means they're exactly the same size and shape. And we're given that AB is equal to BC is X. So in fact, I'm going to just put that in quick. So the length of AB is X. I'm not going to worry about the unit for the moment. And BC is X. And P is a point on AF and Q is a point on CD such that BP equals BQ equals 10. Again, I'm just going to draw that on. So the length of BP is equal to 10 and the length of BQ is equal to 10. So in general, when you've got a diagram and they give you information and the information is not on the diagram, it really helps to visualise it by writing that information on the diagram. We're also given that the angle ABC is 30 degrees. So I'm going to put that in here. So it's that whole angle, ABC. And we need to prove that cos of the angle PBQ is this complicated expression we have there. Now, you might see based on the information I put in the diagram, it looks like we might have some triangles. And we have ways of dealing with angles and side lengths and triangles. We can use some trigonometry. So let's try and draw out these triangles separately and see if that's going to help us. So if I draw a line from P to Q, we can see we've now got a triangle PBQ, and let's draw that out separately. So PBQ, and let's put the information on there. We got the 10. We don't know the length of the bottom. And actually, we've got this angle here, PBQ. We're trying to find this angle here. Now, just for convenience, I'm going to call it theta, just so I don't have to write out PBQ all the time, but that is just theta. So we're trying to find cos of theta. Then we've also got this second triangle. We can see that AB is X, BC is X, and we've got the angle ABC. So if I put a line here, we've got this second triangle, ABC, and we've got that this is 30 degrees, and we've got that's X and that's X. Now, do you notice from the diagram that the length of AC is the same as PQ? And we can use that to relate the two triangles. So just for convenience, I'm gonna call it Y. It just has to be something that's not a variable already used. I can't use X again. So I'm gonna call these both Y. And I'm gonna use that to relate the two triangles. And remember, we're trying to find cos of theta. So, let me put the theta in here. This angle here we said was theta. So we're trying to find cos of that angle. So it might help to start with the triangle on the right first, this one, ABC, because that's going to give us an expression for Y in terms of X. And then, once we've got this Y, an expression for Y, we can use it in this triangle to then find an expression for the theta, for cos of theta. Now, how do we relate the angle of a triangle and the three side lengths? If it's not a right-angled triangle, we can use the cosine rule. So let me just remind you of the cosine rule. So we've got a triangle and we've got an angle here, just one angle in it, A, capital A. Remember, the way we label the sides and angles is that if that's the capital angle A, then directly opposite is the side little a, so it's just a lowercase version, and then the other sides we can just label as B and C. We don't need to label the other angles for this particular problem. And the cosine rule is that A squared equals B squared plus C squared minus 2BC cos A. And that is the cosine rule. So that's going to be useful to apply to these two triangles that we have at the top here. So let's apply it to the blue triangle first. If I just label these sides, in fact, we've got that this is the angle capital A. That's the only angle that we have here. This is the only angle we have, capital A. So that's capital A, which means the opposite side is going to be lowercase a. And then the other side is just B and C in either order. And I'm now going to use that with the cosine rule. So we've got little a squared, which is y squared, is equal to b squared, which is x squared, plus c squared, which is also x, so x squared, minus 2bc, so x times x, which is x squared, times by the cos of the angle A, so cos of 30 degrees. Now let's just try and simplify this. We can simplify this as 2x squared, because x squared plus x squared is 2 lots of x squared. And we've got minus 2x squared. What is cos of 30? Well, we explore exact trigonometric ratios in another video, but I'm just going to tell you cos of 30 is root 3 over 2. If you did that on the calculator, that's what it would give you. But you can work it out without a calculator. And then this over 2 here and this 2 here, they cancel. 2 over 2 just cancels to 1. So we're left with 2x squared minus root 3x squared. And that's what y squared is. So we're going to use that in a moment. And if you look at this expression we're trying to get to, can you see you've got the 2 minus root 3? It looks like we're on the right track here. Now, if we use it on the other triangle, the orange triangle we've got here, let's do it again. Label the sides and angles. So this is the angle capital A, which means this is the side lowercase a, and the other two sides are B and C. So I'm now going to apply the cosine rule to this other triangle. We're going to get y squared. So that's a squared equals b squared plus c squared. So 10 squared plus 10 squared. Minus 2bc. So 2 times 10 times 10. Multiplied by the cos of the angle. Well, the angle A we've made theta. So it's going to be cos of theta. And again, let's just simplify this. So we get y squared equal to 100 plus 100, that's 200, minus 2 times 10 times 10 is 200 again, cos of theta. Now, we know what y squared is because we did it in blue with the other triangle. So we can now substitute that in. I'm just going to transfer to black. So the y squared is 2x squared minus root 3x squared equals that right-hand side. So 200 minus 200 cos of theta. Now let's look what we're trying to prove. We're trying to prove cos of theta, cos of angle PBQ is something. So we just need to make cos of theta the subject of the equation, and then we're done with the proof. And we've hopefully shown we're going to get that expression there. So how are we going to do that? Well, I'm going to add the 200 cos theta to both sides first. So 200 cos theta plus 2x squared minus root 3 x squared is equal to just 200. And then we're still trying to get the cos of theta on its own, so I want to get rid of these other terms here. What can we do? We can do 200 cos theta, and we're going to subtract these other terms around it. Now I'm going to do 200 minus, and then we can subtract all of this, the 2x squared minus root 3 x squared, like that. And we're getting very close to the target expression now. We want cos of theta on its own. I'm going to divide both sides by 200. So if we do that, the 200 divided by 200 is just 1. And this whole bracketed thing I can put over 200. So we're going to get 2x squared minus root 3 x squared. All, 2x squared minus root 3 x squared all over 200. And it's very close now. I can see that the x squared here is sort of outside the fraction, and they sort of factorise that 2 minus root 3 out, so we could do that. We've got 1 minus, and then factorise the x squared out. We've got 2 minus root 3 times by x squared over 200. And because we said the theta was equal to PBQ, we can just write that explicitly. We got cos of angle PBQ is equal to 1 minus 2 minus root 3 over 200 x squared. And that exactly matches this expression we wanted to show. So the proof is complete. And that's the end of the question. Thank you for watching, and please do subscribe.